Chief guest, I now take this opportunity to invite Sid Chatterjee, the UN country, the UN resident coordinator, to make his remarks. Karibu, Sid.
Excellency CS Treasury Ukuriatani, Excellency CS Margaret Kobia, PSS present, CSS present, my brother, the head of the NCPD, good to meet you. Demola, the UNFPA representative, ladies and gentlemen, all protocols observed. Salaam alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. Good morning. It is an eventful day today. It is eventful on many counts. I'm actually in the presence of two people that I greatly admire, and I have to give you a very short anecdote to this. C.S. Yatani used to be the governor of Marsabit County when I used to be in Demola's shoes as the UNFPA representative in this country. And we launched a program in six counties, Marsabit, Mandera, Vajil, Garissa, Lamu, and Isiolo, to reduce the maternal mortality ratios in these six counties. These six counties contributed to 50% of the deaths. The charge that C.S. Yatani led over there was quite dramatic. In fact, I'm not sure if you're aware, but 2015 was the first time that Marsabit County had the first C-section operation. So you can imagine how left out of the national development many of the frontier counties were, where the delivery of a child, the premature delivery of a child, was a death sentence for the child. In that county, suddenly, with the presence of incubators, they were able to start actually preserving life. I also witnessed the signing of the cross-border agreement in Moyale between Kenya and Ethiopia, where the two heads of state, President Kenyatta and that time Prime Minister Haile Mariam, came together. And in CS Margaret Kobia, we have someone who's a true champion of gender. She will not hide away from pulling the punches. She has warned Kenya. We have seen a spike of 45% in cases of sexual and gender-based violence. That is not who we are as a society, not in this country. That is not who we represent in terms of our cultural norms and heritage. And this is something that we have to fight with resilience. And that is why when I saw the ICPD conference happen here in November 2019, ladies and gentlemen, please understand, it didn't happen just because it was Kenya. There were many countries in the world that wanted to have this conference hosted there. Because the previous conference 25 years ago was in Egypt. Kenya was chosen for a reason. Kenya was seen as a flag bearer in the advancement of gender issues. I think the First Lady of Kenya, Margaret Kenyatta, really put this country on the global map in the charge with the Beyond Zero initiative. It got noticed everywhere. And there was resilience, there was purpose, there was commitment. I saw the launch of the Beyond Zero campaign in Mandera County. That time, our former UNFPA executive director, the dear departed Dr. Babatunde Osatayman, was there. Counties which were at one time even not considered safe enough to go to have started seeing transformation thanks to the Beyond Zero. Because what Kenya has shown is political will, and it's that political will that got noticed. So what happened in 2019 will happen 25 years later. What we want to see is Kenya becoming that role model of a country for the rest of the world. And it truly can be. It is. Look at the technology, look at the innovation, look at the big data which is happening, really, which is taking shape in this country. Can we look at new public-private partnerships to achieve that kind of scale and momentum? Absolutely possible. Because Kenya is blessed with three things. Number one,
strong political will. I was actually witness to a meeting in March last year when President Kenyatta was sitting with the executive director of UNFPA, Natalia Kanem, and said, help us eradicate FGM. I want this to be a legacy. It's a very strong political commitment to make. And that is why I'm really pleased to see how UNFPA, UNICEF, the government, you know, spearheaded by CS Margaret Kobia and the anti-FGM board, is really moving this agenda ruthlessly. Because if we can eradicate FGM, we will end the scourge of child marriage. We will start allowing girls to achieve their full human potential. And then the primacy of those three zeros of zero preventable maternal deaths, zero unmet needs of family planning, zero gender-based violence will start taking shape. And then we will see household prosperity. Women and girls, women will be able to plan their families, contribute to the family income. There'll be more disposable income, better nutrition, better education, better access to opportunities for the children there. Again, to me, Kenya is that role model. So it has got strong political will. It's got great public policies. It's about ensuring. It had criminalized FGM long time ago. It is how do we ensure those public policies are properly implemented. And this is where the UN, the entire UN family of 23 UN funds and programs will work with you on this. But the third is partnerships. The kind of public-private partnerships we are seeing in this country, other countries are trying to emulate it. With CS Amina Mohammed, that time she was the foreign minister of this country, we launched the first SDG public-private partnership platform during the UN General Assembly in 2017. I don't know how many of you are aware, but Kenya was invited to the World Economic Forum for the dramatic drop it showed in terms of mortality, maternal mortality ratio. When I came here in 2014, it was 488 deaths per 100,000 live births. By 2017, it was down to about 360 deaths per 100,000 live births. Now, in many countries, these would take about 10 to 15 years to achieve. So it is a country of great promise. It is about how do we now make sure that this drive, that the direction and momentum that the ICPD conference has given us, with the energy and enthusiasm of the head of state of a country who has gone to the micro level of advancing this, will what will shape the new horizon in this COVID environment. Because remember, the COVID is a global challenge of global proportions. It is challenging science, it is challenging medicine, it is challenging everything. But it should not challenge our humanity. It should not challenge our compassion. So I will now want to just acknowledge the importance of the World Population Day. We will be 10 billion people on this planet by 2050. Every day, there are 3,000 Kenyans born. Every day. From the time you woke up this morning, by the time you go to bed. Every year, there is about 1.2 million Kenyans, you know, being born. Every year, about 1 million Kenyans are joining the workforce. Every year, we are barely creating about 150 to 200,000 jobs. What is going to be the next employment opportunity for those young Kenyans to look into that future? The issue is that by 2030, Kenya's population will be 65 million. That's a given. By 2050, at the current rate of a total fertility rate of 4.1, Kenya's population will be at about 100 million. The population of the sub-region of Kenya, Uganda, Rwanda, Ethiopia, Tanzania would be about 600 million. With the youngest population profile, that by 2050 it will be 2.3 billion in Africa, of which 850 million will be young people. This is where the future of consumption and production is going to happen. Can we get ahead to make sure that Kenya becomes that role model for the rest of the region, for the Horn, in advancing that economic trajectory? Because the rest of the world is aging. The West is aging. Kenya's median age is 18. Sweden's median age is 47. So it's a tremendous opportunity for us on how to reap a demographic dividend. And that demographic dividend will only be reaped when we start looking at the entire issue of sexual reproductive health and rights. So finally, it comes down to that girl child and the woman at the center. So I want to end by an appeal that I always make to all political parties, all political leaders across the country. let's make Kenya the role model of passing the two-third gender bill. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sid, for your insightful remarks, and especially by telling us that by the year 2030, and you know 2030 is 10 years to come, Kenya's population will be about 65 million. That is the time we shall have ended up the Vision 2030. At that time, maybe we shall start now talking about Vision 2063. Thank you very much. And you are actually a true friend of Kenya, because Sid is always very positive about our country. And he always encourages us to go ahead and become a leader in the area. Thank you very much for your insightful remarks.